生きてゆくことの意味、問いかけるその度に胸をよぎる愛しい人々の温かさ。
I miss choice in video games.No, not choices like how I go about doming the next unnamed single note red shirt with my wide and varied arsenal of weapons. No, what I miss is story choices. Branching paths or the little details that make the game feel like a thought-out world. Not a movie spliced together with set pieces. Take the Tomb Raider reboot. If you 100% the game, the story is laid out and you know what is going to happen, but Lara doesn't act on it. She reads the notes.I read the notes. It doesn't make sense. I have opinions on that trilogy of games. I've noticed this trend since the 2010s with AAA games to have a straight story. No branching choices. I mean, how can you make a clean-cut sequel to come out on an annual release schedule? Who needs engaging stories when be anyone sandbox open worlds are the hot thing? I mean...Come on, look at that tower. Wanna climb on top of that? The world is living and breathing. No need to discover anything. Here's a map with waypoints to keep you busy. Be safe in our amusement park. Yes, when I had been through this strenuous, abusive relationship in the game, they strapped me to the bed and forced me not to make any choices. Destiny is an exercise of patience. Sure, there are highs and low lows. However, since Forsaken, I've been done.Indifferent to a game I worshipped for, Jesus, almost 10 years. I packed my things, took the dog, and left them. I've changed onto better and brighter things. I check in from time to time, as you do, but nothing excited me. They got cold and were down bad. All my self-discovery next to nofap, rise and grind hype men, stoicism, and nihilism,I read Be Like Water, My Friend, by Shannon Lee. With Beyond Light, it forced you to take a darkness subclass. I refused. The world was black and white, light and darkness. Stasis would taint me. Greater Guardians have fell to its intoxicating power. I was scared. My gears started to turn.
It is important to draw wisdom from many different places. If we take it from only one place, it becomes rigid and stale.Understanding others, the other elements, and the other nations will help you become whole.
Two elemental forces, one we barely scratched the surface on, that have left countless civilizations to be executed just to save themselves, the other we dare not touch. Only taking knowledge from one is making me stale. The knowledge I know is brittle. Maybe this is the case of yin and yang. In the East, we consider yin and yang as two separate things.Two extremes, hot and cold, where in the East they are considered yin-yang, no and. They complement one another, working together to make the whole experience. As guardians, we need both, not one or the other. Without both, there is no growth. We don't have to be part of the shadows of yore with darkness inside of us. They were consumed, taken. We must not. To master this power,with caution, would be a benefit. The stranger saw us being consumed in the darkest timeline. We have both inside of us now. We must be like water.
I'm telling you, don't tense up.
How am I gonna knock someone out if it's all limp?
It's not about strength or power. You gotta be fluid.
Huh?
You have to be like water.
Hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
How did you do that?
You're tense, I'm calm. You apply excessive force, and I control that force through fluid motion. That means relaxing the whole body so it can react instantly without resistance, you know, without thought. Do you see now? It means becoming like clear water.
Water.
Right. Water can take any form. It drifts without effort one moment, then pounds down in a torrent the very next.
But balance doesn't mean equal. A sea half of water and half of poison is not balance. a body half alive and half dead is not balance. To learn from the shadows of yore, the darkest timeline, from Aramis, we must understand balance in ourselves and be fluid. This power has consumed so many in this flower game. Will the Winnowa, the deep, the darkness, the witness, lose finally? There is still hope. Hope for the future, hope for us, hope for those that come after. Hope shines brightest in the dark, where nothing is ever seen. I just hope that we can be strong enough to break the cycle. But hope dies like nothing else. That's what I'm most scared of. Until next time.
Say that the days ahead will be the best of all.
You might try then, as I did, to find a sky so full of stars it will blind you again. Only no sky can blind you now. Even with all that iridescent magic up there, your eye will no longer linger on the light. It will no longer trace constellations. You'll care only about the darkness, and you'll watch it for hours, for days, maybe even for years, trying in vain to believe you're some kind of indispensable, universe-appointed sentinel, as if just by looking you could actually keep it all at bay. It will get so bad you'll be afraid to look away. You'll be afraid to sleep. Then, no matter where you are, in a crowded restaurant or some desolate street, or even in the comfort of your own house, you'll watch yourself dismantle every assurance you ever lived by. You'll stand aside as a great complexity intrudes, tearing apart, piece by piece, all of your carefully conceived denials, whether deliberate or unconscious, and then, for better or for worse, you'll turn unable to resist, though try to resist you will, fighting with everything you've got not to face the thing you most dread. What is now, what will be, what has always come before, the creature you are, the creature we all are, buried in the nameless black of a name. And then, the nightmares will begin.